Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining why the BGP Best Path Algorithm is so complex. Interior Gateway Protocols, or IGPs, like EIGRP or OSPF, typically use a metric or a cost to dynamically determine the best path to a particular destination network. Now, BGP uses a much more complex, granular, and intricate algorithm to determine the best path using a series of attributes. Now, someone may ask, why such complexity? Why not just have the simplicity of a metric and be done with it? Why do we need to deal with all of these complicated attributes that have to be processed and evaluated and compared? Well, it's because BGP has a completely different design philosophy and purpose than IGPs. Let's dive right into the philosophy to find out more. Now, BGP routes traffic on the internet. The internet is essentially an internetwork of networks. These networks are owned and operated by organizations that manage them. And these organizations are known as Internet Service Providers, or ISPs. But they're not the typical ISP that we've come to know. These ISPs operate at different levels. Here we see a high-level diagram of the structure of the internet with Tier 1, Tier 2, and Tier 3 ISPs. At the very basis of the internet, we have the Tier 1 ISP, which operates at an international level and is considered the backbone of the internet. These ISPs are the companies that interconnect continents over deep-sea fiber optic cables and other high-speed backbone links. Then we have Tier 2 ISPs, which are those that can be considered the intermediate distribution ISPs that typically operate within a country or a region. Tier 2 ISPs connect the internet backbone to Tier 3 ISPs. Tier 3 ISPs are those ISPs that deliver connectivity to the end user. This is the telco that you actually buy your broadband connectivity from. Now, the structure you see here in the diagram is essentially why BGP uses autonomous systems, or ASs, to deal with routing. Because each of these ISPs is comprised of one or more BGP ASs, and BGP uses those ASs as the fundamental building blocks through which it performs its routing operations. Now, internet traffic must be exchanged between these entities, and there are rules that govern how that traffic is exchanged. Some rules are technical, others are legal, and still others are financial. But all of these rules contain a level of complexity that is beyond what a mere IGP can provide. For this reason, the attributes of BGP have been designed to allow for a very detailed configuration of how traffic is routed and exchanged between these entities, taking into account all of these parameters. So BGP does not only focus on performance, but also on policies, both technical and non-technical, as well as stability and scalability at a worldwide scale. So where IGPs are designed for routing within an autonomous system, often within an enterprise network, BGP is primarily used for routing between autonomous systems, which means it must manage the vast global internet routing table. So BGP is not just about the shortest or the most efficient route. All of these other aspects and parameters must be taken into account when deciding how to route traffic on the internet. Now, if you're the administrator of a particular AS on the internet, then you are responsible for routing traffic to neighboring ASs. These interconnections often involve complex peering relationships and routing policies that you have negotiated with the owners of these other ASs. There's almost always a contractual obligation to route your neighbor's traffic in a particular way, or for your neighbor to route your traffic as you have requested it. You may want to route traffic based on a multitude of parameters, including cost. You may want to route traffic first through the cheapest AS to save money. You may also want to influence incoming traffic, causing your neighboring ASs to come into your network from the entry point that you choose. You may want to prefer routes that don't include a particular AS due to its unreliability. Or you may want to treat incoming traffic that traverses a particular AS in a specific way due to security concerns or a particular service level agreement. Or you may want to implement traffic engineering, where you dynamically control and optimize the flow of data traffic within your AS or between your AS and neighboring ASs to achieve certain goals, such as load balancing, reduced latency, or increased bandwidth utilization. So BGP, and specifically the attribute list of BGP, allows you to do all of these things and more. As you become more familiar with this protocol, you will begin to see the elegance in its design. After all, BGP was originally conceived in 1989, and it's still vital today. That's an eternity in the telecom industry. Of course, it has changed and developed over time, but at its core, it's still the same protocol. And this is a testament to its excellent design and logical approach. An approach I believe you will come to admire and almost revere as you get to know the protocol better. So just to summarize, BGP routing is fundamentally based on both technical and non-technical policies. BGP is designed to implement complex routing policies based on factors like business agreements, transit costs, and traffic engineering. BGP is also concerned more with stability over speed. Rapid changes in the global internet routing table can lead to instability, so BGP has mechanisms to dampen such frequent route changes. And BGP also focuses on granularity and flexibility. It provides the ability to make routing decisions based on many criteria, including prefix length, influencing inbound or outbound traffic patterns, and selecting different paths for different prefixes. Given BGP's role in managing the global internet routing table, its design has naturally evolved to be more complex and flexible than conventional IGPs. This complexity allows it to handle the nuances and requirements of inter-AS routing at a scale that IGPs are simply not designed for. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other topics related to BGP, feel free to let me know in the comments. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.